If there was one thing that you would think we would all agree on when it comes to low back pain, it would be lifting mechanics, in that we should all brace our core whenever we're picking something up, and that we should also not bend through the low back, but instead lift through our hips and knees. But does the research actually support this kind of guidance when it comes to lifting mechanics and low back pain? A systematic review by David Nolan, published in the Scandinavian Journal of Pain, looked at lifting techniques in people with low back pain compared to those without low back pain. And in total, this systematic review included 9 studies, which looked at both kinematics as well as muscle activation while lifting. And what this systematic review found was that even though there were some inconsistencies between what these studies found, is that overall, those experiencing low back pain, they lifted more slowly, they used their legs more, and they also had less jerky movements when actually performing a lift. And when they looked at the larger studies in those with more severe low back pain, what they found was that they tended to lift through a smaller range of motion in their low back, and then they also tend to have higher muscle activation of the muscles around the low back. And these results aren't necessarily surprising. When somebody's experiencing low back pain, we typically see that they're moving a little bit more slowly, they're a little bit more cautious with their movements, they're trying to avoid aggravating the low back, so they're gonna use their legs more and try not to move the low back. So those findings aren't necessarily surprising. But when we dig a little deeper and look at actually why people move like this when they're experiencing low back pain, it does become a little bit more interesting. And this systematic review gave 3 possible reasons why people move like this when they're experiencing low back pain. One of the reasons why people with low back pain might default to these lifting patterns is because they're trying to protect the spine from excessive loading. And when we look at the research as a whole for low back pain, there's quite a few studies that have found that repeated lumbar flexion are associated with the development of low back pain, and more specifically, discogenic low back pain. However, those studies are typically performed in vitro, meaning that they're performed outside of a living organism, whether it's a pig model or a human cadaver model. But when we look at in vivo studies, so studies that are performed actually inside of a living organism, those associations, whether it's spinal loading and or spinal posture, don't have a very strong correlation with the development of low back pain. The second reason why people with low back pain might default to this lifting pattern is because it's actually a learned pain behavior. So when they actually experience low back pain, their system becomes guarded, their muscles get tight in a way to protect their tissues, especially from the dangers of lifting. So whenever they go to lift, their body actually tenses up as a way to protect itself from any further potential tissue damage. And the third potential reason why people with low back pain might default to this style of lifting is because it's actually what they've been told to do, that a squat style lift is safer for the low back compared to a stoop style lift. And this makes sense because when someone's experiencing low back pain, they might be a little bit more diligent, so they're going to follow advice that they've heard, which is typically that if they do a squat style lift, it's actually going to be protective for their spine. And when looking at the results of this study, it's pretty interesting, especially when we think about the advice that we give to either people experiencing low back pain or those who are looking to prevent low back pain when it comes to lifting technique, in that our advice is usually universal, that you should brace the core so that the spine remains in neutral, and that when you're actually lifting, you should lift through your knees and your hips and never through the low back. But when we look at the research behind lifting biomechanics and the development of low back pain, that relationship isn't nearly as strong as we would think it is. We typically say that if you lift with poor biomechanics, you're going to experience low back pain, but the research really doesn't support that relationship. And so when it comes to advice on lifting mechanics, we really don't have one go-to method for how we should lift. It probably depends a lot on the individual and also on the certain circumstance that somebody is lifting.